As usual, Home Assistant have a new release every month, and it is time for Home Assistant 2022.6, which will bring some new stuff on the table. It will continue to streamline the user experience, and there will be some breaking changes. Let's discuss everything about 2022.6. And by the way, if you still don't have Home Assistant, why are you still waiting? Check my Home Assistant webinar, where I'm discussing all 4 official ways to get Home Assistant, plus one secret and stupid easy way to get it. Register now on my website automatelike.pro/webinar and instantly join the webinar. It's absolutely free, exactly as the new features in Home Assistant 2022.6. Let's see them. The Logbook menu can now be opened from a lot of places, it is faster and it has more information. On top, the logs are live. If I go to my area section of Home Assistant and if I choose one of the areas, I can see the logbook as a card right here. If I open a device inside this area, again the logbook can be seen on this right side. I'll go back, and if I open an entity, I'll click on this, you can see the logbook here again. But if I press this button, this entity, the logbook record will be immediately shown right here. As you can see, everything is updated live now. Next is manage application credentials from the UI. Starting from Home Assistant 2022.6, you can manage OAuth 2 credentials directly from the UI. The new menu is kind of hidden. It is situated in the integrations 3-dots menu, application credentials. But anyways, what actually can do with this application credentials management from UI? Let's say you want to integrate Spotify to your Home Assistant. From the bird's eye view, the Spotify integration procedure is as follows. You have to log into Spotify developer portal, you have to create an app from the menus there, and then you can get your OAuth credentials. Before Home Assistant 2022.6, you had to enter these credentials in your configuration.yaml file and to restart. Now you can add your OAuth credentials from the application credentials menu in the Home Assistant UI, and no restart is required. On top, you can use the My Home Assistant link as a redirect URI during the app creation of Spotify or other compatible integration. So, OAuth 2 management is a lot easier in 2022.6, and it is warm welcomed and streamlined feature. Next new Home Assistant 2022.6 feature is related to the energy dashboard. From now on, you'll be able to compare energy data against previous periods. Very useful visual representation that can lead to some energy saving insights right away. Next, in the latest Home Assistant 2022.6 list is improved scene editor. The new thing here is that you can set the state of a specific entity and not on the whole device when you are creating scenes in Home Assistant. Let me know in the comments, are you using scenes in Home Assistant, and get some bonus points if you say for what exactly are you using them. Will this new scene editor will be of any help for you? Type your answer below. Next is one really useful new feature in Home Assistant 2022.6 called the calendar trigger offset. Using this in Home Assistant automations allows you to make alerts ahead of the actual calendar event. Something like a reminder 15 minutes before a meeting or something. Let's see that in action, as it is so cool and it is probably my most favorite feature in this release. I have created this test event in my Google Calendar, which is starting in 18 minutes. I'll go to my Home Assistant and I'll navigate to my automation section. I'll create a new automation. I'll start with an empty one. The name of the automation will be Alert Before Google Calendar Event. The trigger will be Calendar. And this is what's new here in 2022.6. I have this offset now. So when event start, first I have to select my calendar. Google Calendar is integrated with my Home Assistant, so I can select this as entity. So when there is an event in Google Calendar, I can set an offset, for example, 15 minutes before. And as action, I'll call a service. The service will be persistent notification create. And the message will be a Google Calendar event will start in 15 minutes. I'll hit save. And when this becomes 10:45, I should receive a new notification right here. Let's see. Boom! I have a new notification. A Google Calendar event will start in 50 minutes. Everything is working as expected. Great new feature. I like it. The next two features in Home Assistant 2022.6 are not so shiny, but they are important, especially the latter, where the next one in the list is the hardware integrations. This one will be further developed, but for now just know that if you're running Home Assistant on a Raspberry Pi and your power adapter is not providing enough power, the Home Assistant will let you know. The second, not shiny from the end-user perspective point of view change in Home Assistant 2022.6 is yet another database performance optimization. These optimizations technically are impressive, as they can increase the life of your storage device due to less writes operations and reduce the DB size. Just have in mind that the DB size reduction will not be available right after the update. The data stored in the database before 2022.6 will not get updated, and the DB reduction will occur over time with the recording of new data and the purging of old data. Now is the best time to discuss one big breaking change in Home Assistant 2022.6. Before that, let me know which is your most favorite feature in the Home Assistant 2022.6. Please share your answer in the comments. Now, back to the breaking change. Actually, this one is really important, but will not break anything right away. It is more likely a 3 months deprecation notice, so you have time to fix your Home Assistant configuration if that is actually needed. It all depends whether you have any manual MQTT configurations. If you have manual MQTT entities in your configuration.yaml file, you have to update their format as follows. I'll go to the release notes of Home Assistant 2022, and under breaking changes, the first one is MQTT. And inside you can see the old format, the current format right here, which is going to be removed in Home Assistant 2022.9. If you don't have any of these in your configuration.yaml, congratulations, you don't have to do anything. Otherwise, you have 3 months to update this. For now, the current format of MQTT will work, but you have to go to the new format before the Home Assistant 2022.9 release. And this is the updated format. As you can see, there are a few differences. The sensor is now below the MQTT section, and there is no platform MQTT. So if you have such entities in your configuration.yaml file, you better update them in the next few days, weeks, or even months, but not before the Home Assistant 2022.9 release. Download my free smart home glossary if you want to have a PDF document full of simple explanations of the most used smart home words and abbreviations. With smart home glossary or not, stay around for more smart home related content, as I will release my new video next Wednesday. I'm Kirill, and I'm done speaking. Bye!